हेलो स्टूडेंट्स ऑफ क्लास 9, सो दिस इज़ द फर्स्ट चैप्टर दैट यू हैव इन योर क्लास 9 सिलेबस, द अर्थ एज अ प्लैनेट. ओके, प्रीवियसली इट वॉज थॉट बाय द पीपल दैट द अर्थ इज अ फ्लैट डिस्क. व्हाई? बिकॉज व्हेन दे स्टैंड दे कैन सी द सन अबव देम, दे कैन सी द मून अबव देम. ओके, फ्रॉम दिस थिंग दे हैव थॉट दैट द अर्थ इज अ फ्लैट disk with some edges, and there is a sky above it because and the sun and the moon are rotating around the earth. It was Ferdinand Magellan who first gave the proof that earth is a sphere, not a flat surface. Then Pythagoras, who was an Greek mathematician and a philosopher, postulated that the earth is a sphere about 600 years ago. And finally, around 350 BC, the great Aristotle first declared that the earth is a sphere, not a flat surface. Okay, Aristotle gave this declaration based on the three observations. First one is that gradual disappearance of the ships over the distant horizon, number two is that the earth cast a curved shadow. Next, number third observation is that variation in the elevation of the sun and stars with latitude. So, based on these three observations, Aristotle first declared that the earth was was round or sphere-like object. I'm going to go into in details of these three observations. The next is proof of earth's sphericity. Okay, so the first proof is that circumnavigation of the earth. Okay, it was first believed that the earth was a flat surface. Okay, so Ferdinand Magellan started a journey with some crew and sailed over the oceans, and the concept that first used to believe that the earth is a flat surface with some edges, but they never found any edges. When they were traveling, they thought they can go like this way without any edge. They are traveling, I mean, they traveled in a circular manner and return to the same point from where they have started. So in this way they proved that the earth is spherical in nature, or earth is circular in nature rather than it is a flat surface area. Next proof is that circular horizon. Okay, when we stand on a particular place of the land, we can see in the front that the sky has merged with the surface of the earth. Okay, it merges in a circular margin or a line means this line we are talking, and this is known as the horizon. So from this it gives the proof that the earth is circular in nature, not a flat disk. The next point is gradual visibility. Okay, when we see a ship that comes, at first we generally see first the topmost portion or the flag portion of the ship, then we can see the little bit more portion of the ship visible, and slowly when it approaches near the place of the area where we are standing, then we can see the full ship. Okay, but if earth would have been flat like this, then we could have seen the full ship at first sight, not part by part, like first the uppermost part, then the little bit more, then the it become more and more visible. Okay, so from this part we can understand that the earth is sphere in shape. Because it is spherical in shape, we can see the part of the ship, ship's part, means one part after one part. But if the earth would have been flat, then we could have seen the full ship at the first instance. The next proof is that sunrise and sunset. We all know that the sun rises in the east and sets in the west. So by this we can understand, because of the rotation of the earth, the sun rises in the east and the sun sets in the west. So this actually proves that the earth is a sphere in shape. Why? Because if the earth would have been flat like that, then all the places on the earth's surface would have got the sunrise at the same point of the time and sunset at the same point of the time. But what we get when we get sunrise in the eastern half, it is dark in the western half. Okay, and when it is sun light in the east western half, we get the darkness in the eastern half. So from this proves actually the earth is spherical in shape, not a flat surface. Because if had been flat surface, then all the places on the earth surface would have got the sun's rays and the sunset at the same time. Next is the lunar eclipse. The earth always cast a carved shadow on the moon during the lunar eclipse, and only a sphere surface can cast this carved shadow. It's not possible for any flat or rectangular or square object to cast a carved shadow. So from this we get the proof that the earth is sphere or spherical in shape, not flat. Next point is that planetary bodies are spherical. When we see into the space, we see that the sun is rounder in shape, then all the planets are rounder in shape, okay, or sphere in shape. So earth being a part of the same solar system, it can't be something different. So from this we are also getting a proof, like all the other planets and the sun, that our earth is also sphere or spherical in shape. The last proof is the traveling around the earth. Okay, if we travel around the earth by a plane or by ship, no one has ever experienced any age. Okay, and this is possible because the earth is rounder in shape, not a flat surface. Okay, so this also gives the proof that the earth is spherical in shape, not a flat surface. So this is all about the proof of the earth's sphericity. I'm going to continue with the next of the chapter in the next video. So thank you everyone.